Hey, Possum Abe.
Sorry, just you in that chair.
I think I would have made a damn fine president.
You would have brought a real dignity to the office.
You're welcome, America.
Welcome to Zombieland. Life is about more than just survival. We were a family. Dysfunctional, sure, but what family isn't?
Merry Christmas!
What would you like, little girl?
I'd really like for you to stop calling me little girl.
But do you know what I would like?
I don't give a shit what you mean.
It felt so good to be on the move again.
Whoa! Oh my God, I'm so sorry. Hi, I'm Columbus.
Madison.
This is Tallahassee.
Hey, Paul Blart. Is this your dad? I forgot the seatbelt rule.
Oh, so she knows the rules?
I told her just a few of them.
73, and are there more?
You're cute. I like it. My sister is gone. She picked up a boy. He's from Berkeley.
Berkeley!
You don't have weed, do you?
Do I look like the type of person that would have weed?
I'm sorry.
Boom! Yeah?
I have nothing against
hippies. I just want to beat the shit out of them. We're gonna go get her. We ride it, dog.
Start talking.
You first.
Well, my name's Tallahassee.
Die, zombie! Light him up! No! That's my ride!
Oh, my apologies, little Elvis.
Okay, is it me, or does he kind of remind you of...
I don't like you. At all.
I think you double parked. Omar. Perpendicular parked. Hope we don't get a ticket.
What is going on here?
What?
Hello, everyone.
Am I hallucinating?
Ba-ba-ba-ba. This is your seven. That's right, your seven. This is your seven of movie month. For 30 days, I'll watch 30 movies and do 30 podcasts. This is day seven.
So, all right, just got to back up here a little bit. Burger King has this breakfast treat called the Eggnormous Burrito, which I discovered, because I don't know, either it was through a commercial, an ad or something, I don't know. I've had it before, and look, it's Burger King. What are you going to say? It's not good for you food, but it was quite delightful. Now, I am driving out of a Burger King parking lot right now, and let me just let you know that the Eggnormous Burrito is not available in the Pleasant Street Burger King in Methuen. And why am I driving out of Burger King at 9 a.m. in the morning, you may ask? Well, if you have been following along with me on the bike story, if you've been listening to the podcast, you know that bought a bike, built a bike. My wife fell off a bike. We tried the bike again. That was the plan. And, she tried the bike yesterday. And I tried the bike yesterday. And it works fine. But it's too big for her. Like, she's short. And the bike is not. And I just thought, oh, it's an adult bike. Fine. Not the case. So, you may ask yourself, well, what does that have to do with Burger King or driving at 9 o'clock in the morning on a Sunday morning? Well, that means once you buy a bike that doesn't, fit exactly, when you buy a bike on Amazon, returning it after you built it, I don't know the logistics of that. I'm sure it's possible. But what's probably going to happen is she's going to list that for sale someplace on Facebook, try to recoup as much money as we can. In the meantime, she goes on Facebook, finds a bike that she likes. It's used. It's a lot cheaper. Should have done this in the first place. And it's in a place called Chelsea, Massachusetts, which is about 35 minutes away from where I live. Hence the car, hence the driving, hence the Burger King, because that's me taking care of myself. That's me getting a little something for myself whilst driving to Chelsea, Massachusetts to pick up a used bicycle for my wife. The bike story will never end. But that's not what I'm here for. That's not what I'm here to talk about today. I'm here to talk about movie number 7. On the 7th day of June, I watched a 7th movie. And this was another sequel. Now, I say another sequel because, well, I watched... Okay, I think, has in every other movie been a sequel? No. But the first day was a sequel. The third day was a sequel. Wait a minute. Okay, let's see if I can even remember the movies I did. Hobbs and Shaw, sequel. Parasite, nope. Then we have Uncut Gems, nope. We have Last Blood, yes, sequel. Then we have Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, not a sequel. But wasn't there another sequel in that? Like, I've already lost my movies. This is day 7, and I've already lost a movie. Let's see if we can do this. Okay. Hobbs and Shaw, followed by Parasite, followed by... something else. There's been no superhero movies, right? Hobbs and Shaw, Parasite, Uncut Gems, Once Upon a Time in America. That's 4. Last Blood is 5. There's a 6th movie that I can't remember. Already. 7 days in, the first week, and I've already lost a day. This is incredible. How is this possible? Let's see. HBO, Hobbs and Shaw, Stars. I watched a couple of things. Netflix, Hulu. I am like beside myself that I can't remember. But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Who cares? That's not what this is about. This is about today's movie. And today I watched the 2019 Woody Harrelson film, and Jesse Eisenberg and Emma Stone, and I can't remember the other girl's name. Abigail Breslin. Zombieland, Double Tap, also known unofficially as Zombieland 2. Hold on, gotta put my blinker on. We call it a blinker here, up here, not a directional. It's a blinker. Put your blinker on. Turning into the next lane. I'm right now getting on Route 93 South. If I went Route 93 North, it would take me to Concord, New Hampshire. But Route 93 South is taking me to a place called Boston. I have not been to Boston since March, since you know, the world shut down. But I'm not going to Boston. I'm going to a town nearby. Anyway, that's not the point. The point is, today I watched Zombieland 2, and yeah, it was one of those movies where I was asked to go see it, and I think at the time I just didn't have the chance to go see it, my friends went, I didn't go, want to go, whatever it was. But that's fine, because I had no problem holding off this movie and waiting for it to watch it on TV, on Stars, which is what I did. Spider-Man, that's the one. I knew there was another sequel. My gosh. I went to see the original Zombieland in the theater, and, you know, it looked fun, but I wasn't sure what to get out of it when I went to see it, and it was a lot of fun. And the same thing with this one, a lot of fun. How much can you really talk about it? It's like, apparently it's 10 years later. Well, it is 10 years later. And the 4 of them are still living together. They're in the White House. I'm not sure if that's how the original ended, but they found the White House, and they've been living there for all this time. But they're getting like antsy. The youngest girl is like, wants people her own age. So her and her sister, Emma Stone, which they're not really sisters, right? I forget. They leave, and then Jesse Eisenberg and Woody Harrelson are alone, and then they discover another girl, like a dumb, blonde, ditzy girl. But then Emma Stone comes back because her sister's missing, and now they're basically going on an adventure to go back and make sure the sister's safe. Along the way, they try to go to Graceland because they figure that's where she would be. Then they go to a Graceland hotel run by Rosario Dawson. Luke Wilson and Thomas Middleditch show up, and they're like a carbon copy of Woody Harrelson and Jesse Eisenberg. And, and they discover that the daughter, the youngest girl, is probably headed with this hippie guy to this place called Babylon, or Babylon, as the dummy calls it. Which is like this utopia-type place, which, of course, they have no weapons, which means when the zombies come, all hell breaks loose. Luckily, they get there and show up and save the day. Tallahassee, who is Woody Harrelson's character, saves the day. Look, the plot is what it is. It's the zombies have evolved. Some of them are, you know, they've gotten dumber. They call them those homers. And some of them have gotten smarter. They call those T-800s. They're like Terminators. They keep coming. They don't die easy. Early on in the movie, Woody Harrelson talks about the fact that he has Native American blood in him, and that his ancestors have, were famous for having the running of the buffalo, where the buffalo ran off the cliff. I should have seen that as foreshadowing, because at the end of the movie, he basically almost sacrifices himself, puts himself, his life on the line to get the zombies to chase after him, and then all jump off a cliff, off this giant tower to their death. That wasn't like a famous place, right? It just looked like a really, it's not in California, so it's not the Tower Records or whatever it is building. So that was just a big giant building. Okay, I'm staying in my lane. And they all saved each other, and then Woody Harrelson's like, all right, I'm going to go run out. Oh, no, he was like, I'm going to leave, and then he leaves, he comes back, blah, 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 blah. Oh, they're all happy together in the end, and Rosario Dawson is in love with Woody Harrelson. I'm not sure quite the age difference there, but, it's not a... She's got to be in her 40s, I'm guessing, but he's got to be in his 60s at this point. I don't know. Or 50s. But it's slightly more age-appropriate than being, like, someone in his 20s. And the dumb girl, she stayed behind with the hippie guy and stayed behind in the Babylon place. It was fun because at one point, you know, they're not isolated like something like The Walking Dead. Like, there's a world out there. Electricity still works because the water is still, the dams are still producing electricity, which in a way makes sense. The fact that nobody is manning those stations means that, you know, I guess luck, they're just being lucky. But at least it was I don't know if it makes sense, but at least it was explained. There was a throwaway line of, hey, the dams are still there. So look, thank God we still have electricity. So there you go. And Rosario Dawson is like, oh, I'm sorry, I almost married you. They're like, murdered me? Yeah, I heard that's how Bill Murray died. Someone thought he was a zombie and killed him, which is exactly what happened. And it was Jesse Eisenberg who did it in the original Zombieland. One of the greatest moments the greatest moment of the movie, where he's dying and they're like, do you have any regrets? He's like, Garfield too. Or maybe just said Garfield. Now, earlier in the movie, they did a fun little thing where they're walking by this broken down sign and it says Garfield 3 on it. So they're saying Bill Murray made a Garfield 3. And then at the end, Jesse Eisenberg's like, you know, I feel really bad about what happened to Bill Murray, and it's like, I'd like to honor him by showing you all the way back to the first day of the zombies. So it goes back to the press junket for Garfield 3, and he's there getting interviewed by different people, and he's getting interviewed by Al Roker, and then Al Roker turns into the first zombie, or at least the first zombie we see, and Bill Murray starts, beats him up, kills him, and goes outside to the main lobby, and there's all these kinds of zombies, and he's just kind of nonchalantly smashing zombies, killing zombies, and saying movie phrases. Kenny Loggins is playing from Caddyshack, and at one point he says, I ain't afraid of no ghost. I mean, it was just like, it was Bill Murray being Bill Murray was awesome. I don't know if it was the best part of the movie, because it was like its own little thing, but it was one of my favorite moments of the movie. And the movie itself was fine. It was exactly what I expected. I chuckled, and I enjoyed myself. It was just a fun ride the entire time. And, of course, all the actors in it are enjoyable. You see Jesse Eisenberg. He did this 10 years ago. And he does, maybe he did The Social Network first. Social Network. He does Lex Luthor. He does a couple little movies. You don't see him doing a ton of things. And you forget that he can be this, lighthearted, goofy, almost like Michael Cera type act, you know, character. And it was fun seeing Luke Wilson and Thomas Middleditch show up and basically be carbon copies of them. Yeah, I think that's it. 12 minutes? I still have quite a ride. I still have 20 minutes, and then I have 20 minutes. I said I'd get there for 10, but this map is showing me I'd get there for 9:40, so I'm a little early. But that's fine. I'll pull over and wait a few minutes. Yeah, I think I've covered everything. Not much to say, you know? They do the rules. They show the zombie kill. Now they have zombie kills of the year. Lots of over-the-top violence, cartoonish violence. Them just kind of hanging out in the mall. Seeing Walden Books was funny. Oh, my goodness, I'm yawning. Yeah, so here's the thing. I've never bought anything off Facebook Marketplace before. Purchased anything. I don't know if that's the right English. I never bought nothing. So I could be going to get robbed. I could be going to get fleeced. Or I could just be going to get a bike. But you're on Facebook, and this person's public account. You really don't think they'd list something to try to catfish me into giving them cashish, because I had to stop at the ATM to get some cashish. So, yeah, this bike thing is really just costing me an arm and a leg. And my wife, her elbow, when she scraped it up. Oh! Yeah, that's it, folks. Zombieland Double Tap, Zombieland 2. Short and sweet episode today, because that's all it took. It was a fun movie. Not a ton to talk about. It's not like, oh, the intricate performances, or I see what they did here. No, it's just fun. Just fun. Just seeing just the little, I'm sure there's little things I missed, you know, with the zombies or with the stuff in the background. I did like seeing, you know, like the Garfield 3, the Walden Books in the background. That kind of stuff was cool. Yeah, I'm going to put two hands on the wheel now. I'm going to eat the breakfast sandwich I did get, even though it's not an egg-normous burrito. And I'm going to have my coffee, and I'm going to do that now because I'm starting to get hungry. Hungry, hungry. So, folks, you can find me on Twitter and Instagram at Geek Mentality. The website is Fans Not Experts. The podcast, of course, is Geek Mentality. You can find that everywhere. If you're just listening to this for the first time or found it through the website, yeah, please subscribe. We're available anywhere podcasts are available, and 6 places podcasts aren't available. I can't list those now because of contract disputes that I'm going through with certain entities. But you know it. I know it. Thank you so much for listening. Hopefully, I can stop talking about this friggin' bike going forward. And until tomorrow, my friends, until Monday. And that's the last thing that Bill Murray said. I hate Mondays, which is a Garfield line. But tomorrow is Monday, and I love it because I'm back for another movie. But until then, here is my theme song.
This is my podcast. I made it. Geek Mentality's what I named it. And I think you should listen and subscribe. Cause I'm kinda funny and awesome. I think that I'm worth your time, and I'm kinda handsome. My mom says, please listen and please subscribe. At least listen to this episode.
Fans Not Experts.
I don't want to wait till tomorrow to say this. I'm going to end this bike saga right now. I just wasted gas, mileage, time, everything. Because, yeah, there's no bike. I don't know if that means there's no bike. Now I'm getting lost trying to get out of Chelsea. Get me the hell out of this city. But there was no bike for me. Because I go to the house. There's 4 doorbells because it's a multifamily house. I don't know which button to press. So I press 1, nothing. I press another, nothing. I text the woman, nothing. Some dude comes outside and says, oh, I know who that is. That's my best friend's wife. Oh, great. I saw your bike yesterday. Oh, great. All friendly, very nice. He's like, oh, I got someone here to buy a bike. Okay. Oh, she's not here, man. I'm sorry. I don't know. Her car's not here. She's not here. Now, this guy seemed very friendly and, you know, not like lying to me or anything. But something was fishy because 2 seconds later, I get back in the car and get a text back from her. It's saying, bike sold. I go, oh, I thought when you marked it as sold, that was for us. I sorry, she just writes back. And I'm like, you got to be effing kidding me. I drove 45 effing minutes with $100 in my pocket to buy a phone, to buy a watt, to buy a friggin' bike from this swindling, lying jerk. What else could I say? I mean, there's no way. Oh, I'm so angry. I'm angry. That's it. I'm done. I'm going home. Zombieland 2 was fun, at least. Blah!